2008, our area dominated Jesse Owens Stadium. In the boys' Division III state track and field meet, 11 of the 17 events were won by a local athlete, and another 25 earned All-Ohio honors. Leading the way, a runner from Bluffton who overcame an injury that cost him his junior season, but not the 17th spot on 44's top 44 male high school athletes of the last 10 years.
John Guigenti, Bluffton, class of 2008, track and field. Four-time state champion in 2008, helping lead the Pirates to the team title that year. Set a new state meet record in the 400 in 47.76 seconds to go along with a win in the 200 and anchoring the 4x2 and 4x4 relay teams to the gold. That 4x4 team, John, Ricardo Pena, Zach Guigenti, and Jesse Herr's time of 1 minute 28.47 seconds set the state record. Seven times a state qualifier, was part of the first place 4x400 relay team in 2006. School record holder in the 200, 400, as well as the 4x2 and 4x4 relays.
John did, he hurt his knee playing football. And he had the full knee surgery, didn't play basketball. He had played basketball up to that point, so didn't play his junior, senior year. And when the senior football year came around, he wasn't there. And we were all like, John, you are a great player. You were, leading the team in receptions. What are you doing? And I talked to him, and he said, I'm getting ready for track. And I was, in the back of my head, I thought, oh, John, it doesn't work out when you do that. But it turned into this storybook finish as he put in extra time out in the weight room, on the indoor track, whatever it was. And then when his senior year came about, he just blew everybody away all year long.
Yeah, his senior year, and I kind of know the family pretty well, and I remember going down and had some bets going on with his father about what he was going to do and so forth. And boy, 2008, that Bluffton team was just unreal. And John went down there and broke the state record in the 400 meters. I don't think us in the immediate Lyme area were too surprised how well he's run, because we got a chance to see him at the districts and so forth. But yeah, I can remember being down at the state meet, and he broke the state record in the 400 meters. And I happened to be standing next to some college coaches, and I remember one coach says, wow, he's going to Findlay? How'd we miss this guy? Because like you say, he missed his junior year being hurt. Us in the local area, we can kind of see how good he was even before he got hurt his junior year or sophomore year. But his senior year, he just had quite a run from probably league on, and probably one of the best 400 meter guys I've ever seen around this area.
That was Bluffton's second state title of all time, and he was the leader. He was the anchor of that team, literally and figuratively. And, he led that group. If they were even close, they weren't going to be when he got the baton. One other thing I would say about John is that a lot of sprinters are pretty compact, little guys. John was all a 6'4" and built. Even in high school, he was built. And he took big, long strides, but he had quick turnover. And I just remember him coming down the home stretch at Jesse Owens Stadium with this huge smile on his face in his last race, as they wrapped up the state title. And that's what I think of when I think of John.
Again, you wonder what would happen if he went and got hers his junior year, because I'm sure that put him back a little bit. But I was amazed, like I said, down at state meet in 2008 when he won the title, when a lot of the people down there didn't know who John Guigenti was. But I guarantee you, when the meet was over, they knew who John was.
At Findlay, Guigenti earned All-American honors three times for the Oilers. John Guigenti, number 17 on 44's top 44 male athletes.
Guigenti helps coach Bluffton's track team and is a successful chainsaw artist, as his carvings can be seen at Gethsemane Cemetery in Lima, Veterans Park in Coldwater, as well as numerous yards throughout the area. Really some amazing artistic work you can see on his website on trackcarvings.com. Join us next Friday as 44's Top 44 continues with number 16, a baseball and basketball star from St. Henry. And of course, each Friday from now till June, we'll continue the countdown of 44's Top 44 male athletes right here on the Sports Report.